Hello, Chris Green here with the Flood Insurance Guru. Today we're talking about the FEMA rulebook and how it's impossible to understand. So we're going to go through 26 different videos and we're going to talk about each rule when it comes to the cancellation process with the National Flood Insurance Program or your FEMA policy. You know, this is something we probably get here more than anything at the Flood Insurance Guru. So we want to make sure that you understand all these rules when it comes to cancellation. You know, when can you cancel? When can you can't? Are you getting a prorated refund? Are you getting a complete refund? So we're going to talk about all those things in this series. Thank you. Hello, Chris Green here with the Flood Insurance Guru. Today we're continuing our series on the FEMA cancellation reasons, the 26 reasons. Today we're talking about reason 19. And this is that flood insurance is no longer required because FEMA has removed the building from a special flood hazard area through a letter of map amendment. Now you've heard us talk about some map amendments before. You know, this is when FEMA comes in and looks at your property, looks at the structures on your property and removes them from the flood zone. Then FEMA sends you a letter. That letter's gotta get over to the bank. Now what happens then is the bank has to accept that on their loan. They have to give you a documentation to get the policy canceled. Just like the insured has to cancel it. Now, how's the refund work? You know, are you gonna be able to get the current term back? Well, the way the refund works with FEMA is if this letter of map amendment was completed within 60 days of the effective date of the policy, you know, let's say your policy renews on February 1st, and this was done January 1st, then it's gonna qualify for that refund, you know, on the current term. It just takes a while to get it in. So all these things do have to be submitted to FEMA with that cancellation letter from the bank and the property owner. And it's usually recommended that you submit a copy of the letter or map amendment. Even though FEMA does put these on their website, it can make things easier. So this is how Reason 19 or Code 19 works. When a building is being removed from the special flood hazard area as a result of a letter of map amendment. So if you've got questions about letter of map amendments, if you've got questions about Reason 19 or Code 19 of the FEMA cancellation rules, then please reach out to us. Floodinsuranceguru.com. Go to our YouTube channel, our Facebook page, The Flood Insurance Guru, where we do our daily flood education videos. You can also give us a call, 205-451-4294. Remember, we have an educational background in flood mitigation, which means we can help you with flood risks, like this one right here. Your flood insurance and mitigating your property long-term to help you minimize flood losses and flood premiums. Thank you.